So, hello and welcome to Java Tea Point. And today the topic of discussion is candidate key. And what we are going to understand is method to calculate candidate key. Okay, let's start. So prior to start this, I have already created a video on closure of an attribute. And I request you, if you are directly coming to this video, I request you to kindly watch closure of an attribute first. Okay, so let's start. So what is candidate key? I've already explained you in my video of keys that what is candidate key, but I'll again explain you what is candidate key. Candidate key is a super key. Candidate key is a super key whose no proper subset is a super key. So candidate key is a super key. First of all, the main condition is that candidate key is a super key and whose no proper subset is a super key. Again, now the question is given that you have a super key A, AB, AC, ABC and BC. These all are super key. It's given. These all are super key. This is 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 super. It's given. Now you have to find candidate key. Can this be a candidate key? What is the definition of candidate? Candidate key is a super key. Yes, it's a super key. Whose no proper subset is a super key. The proper subset of AB is what? AC. And which is a super key. So it cannot be candidate key. Can this be a candidate key? It should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. It's no proper subset should be a super key. The proper subset of AC is what? A, and it's a super key, so it cannot be candidate key. Can this be a candidate key? No, this cannot be candidate key because it should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. Its proper subset is A, should not be a super key. It's a super key, so it cannot be a candidate. Can this be a candidate key? Yes, it can be a candidate key because it's a super key and it's no proper subset. What? You cannot further divide single attribute. So it's no proper subset is a candidate key. It's a super key, so it's a candidate key. Now check this BC. The proper subset of BC is what? B and C. Is B and C super key? No, neither B nor C is a super key. So BC is a candidate key. So we have two candidate key. What? A and BC. Fine. So I've tried my level best to explain you. Now we have three questions on candidate key. So I'll solve each and every question one by one. So now we'll start with the question number one. The question number one is that the given a relational schema X, Y, Z, W. There are four columns X, Y, Z and W. Using functional dependency, given the functional dependencies, determine the candidate key. Okay, so let's start. Given R, given functional dependency, determine the candidate key, number of candidate key. So how to determine X, Y, Z? So find the closure of X, Y, Z. X, Y, Z. And I've already told you how to find the closure. The closure of X, Y, Z will have, first of all, X, Y, Z. The closure will have same attribute. Again, with the help of X, Y, Z, you can determine what W. Since with the help of X, Y, Z, you can determine all the attribute of a table. See, with the help of X, Y, Z, with the help of X, Y, Z, you can determine all the attribute of table. So no need to calculate what you will get extra from this. Nothing. So this is what super key. Now I'm not talking of candidate key. I'm just talking of super key. So it's a super key. Fine. Let's calculate the closure of XY. XY. The closure of XY will have XY. Now with the help of XY, you can determine ZW. So write ZW. The closure of XY is what? XYZW. Since the closure of XY is having all the attributes, so this is also what? Super key. Fine. Okay. Now find the closure of X. The closure of X will have what? X. Now with the help of X, you can determine YZW. YZW. Since closure has all the attribute, so this is also what? Super key. Now come to candidate key. What is the definition of candidate key? Candidate key should be a super key. So is this a super key? Yes. Can this be a candidate key? First of all, candidate key should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. Again, the condition is it's no proper subset should be a super key. XYZW, the proper subset is what? The proper, I'm sorry. So this is a super key. Which is a super key? XYZ. XYZ is a super key. XY is a super key. And X is a super key. Not this. This is a super key. Can this be a candidate key? So candidate key definition says candidate key should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. But it's no proper subset. It's no proper subset should be a super key. XYZ is a super key. Yes, it's proper subset. XY is a super key. So it cannot be a candidate key. Can this be a candidate key? Can XY be a candidate key? Candidate XY is a super key. Yes. First condition is satisfied. But its proper subset should not be a super key. XY proper subset is X and is a super key. So this cannot be a candidate key. Fine. So let's start. Can this be a candidate key? It should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. Its proper subset. Now you cannot divide x. So no proper subset of x is existing. So fine. So yes, now we have only one candidate key, that is x. So number of super key you have what? Number of super key you have three super keys, but candidate key you have only one candidate key. Fine. So let me rub this and now start with this question. Okay. So again, determine closure of xy. The closure of xy is what? First of all, xy will have xy, and with the help of xy you can determine z. Fine. So since you are not getting all the attribute, now use this function z. With the help of z you can determine yw. Since y is already there, you no need to write y duplicate again, write w. Since with the help of xy you can determine all the attribute of a table, so xy is what? Super key. So xy is what? Super key. Fine. Now find closure of z plus. So with the help of z you can determine z. First of all, z will have z, and with the help of z you can determine yw. So yw comes, and with the help of w you can determine x. Yes, x comes. Now you can determine all the attribute with the help of using z. You can determine all the attribute z, y, w, x. So this z is what? Super key. Now determine the closure of w plus. So w plus will have w, and with the help of w you can find x. So since it's not having all the attribute, move again up and check xy. Is xy there? No, only x is there. Is z there? No, only x is there. Or w. Is w is there? Yes. With the help of w you can determine x. So you are having only x is already there. So no matter how many times you move, you will only get wx. Since with the help of w you are not finding all the attribute, so this is not super key. So this is not super key. Fine. Now comes the candidate key. What is candidate key? Candidate key says, can this be a candidate? Can xy be a candidate key? Candidate key's definition say, first of all, it should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. Its proper subset should not be a super key. Xy proper subset. The proper subset of xy is what? The proper subset of xy is what? X and y. The proper subset of xy is what? X and y. Fine. The proper subset. Now find the closure of x and y. X closure can have only x. With the help of x, now use function. With the help of x you need xy, there is only x. You need z, there is only x. You need w, there is only x. So with x you find only x. So x is not super key. Now use y. With y plus can have y. Okay, with now you need xy, there is only y. You need z, there is only y. You need w, there is only. So with the help of y plus you can only determine y. So both of the proper subset of xy are not super key. So this is what? Candidate key. Fine. So you found this is a candidate key. Is z is a super key? Yes, z is a super key. Can it be a candidate key? 100%. No need to check. Why? Because z cannot have a further subset, because z is a single attribute. So this is a candidate key. Can this be a candidate key? No, this cannot be a candidate key, because it's not satisfying the first condition, because this is not super key. Since this is not super key, so it cannot be what? Candidate key. So now you have two super key and two candidate key. So finally what you have? You have two super key and you have two candidate key. Fine. Okay, now let me solve this question over here. Okay, let's start. Determine the closure of y plus. Y plus will have y first. With the help of y you can determine x, z, w. So x, z, w. Fine. Let me have a space first. Y plus. So y plus can have y. With the help of this functional dependency it can have x, z, w. Since with y you can determine all the attributes, so this is a super key. Which is a super key? Y is a super key. Fine. Now take the example of x, z, w. X, z, w. X, z, w. Is x, z, w? Find the closure of x, z, w. So x, z, w will have the closure x, z, w. Now with the x, z, w you can determine y. Since all the attribute are here, so this is also super key. Fine. Okay, can this be a candidate key? 100% this can be a candidate key, because first of all it's a super key and it's no proper subset, because y you cannot determine, you cannot divide y. So y is single attribute, and 100% if it is single attribute it's a candidate key. But what about this xz? Can xzw be a candidate key? What is the definition of candidate key? First of all it's a super key. Yes, it's a super key. First of all, it should be a super key. Yes, it's a super key. And it's no proper subset. So what are proper subset of xzw? The proper subset of xzw are xz, xw, zw, x, y, z. Fine. So determine all the closure. If any of these finds out to be a super key, then this will not be a candidate key. Calculate. XZ will have XZ. Find the closure of XZ. XZ will have XZ. And with the help of XZ, you have only Y. You cannot do. You have XZ. What you need for this, you have only XZ. And what you required, XZW. So you have only XZ. So the closure of XZ is only XZ. So it's not a super key. Fine. XW. With the help of XW, if you find the closure of XW, closure is with, you will have XW. And with Y, you have Y. No, you don't have Y. So if you don't have Y, you cannot use this functional dependency. You have XZW. No, you have only XW. So you cannot write Y. So this is also not super key. Now find ZW. So ZW will have ZW. Find the closure of ZW. So with the help of Y, you have Y. No, you don't have Y. You have only ZW. You have XZW. No, you have only ZW. So XZW will have, ZW will have closure only. So this is not super key because it's not determining all the attributes. Fine. Okay. Now determine the closure X. Do you have X? So do XZW will have X, W and Z. Fine. So now determine the closure of X. X will have only X. You have X. No, you have only Y. So Y with help you cannot do. You need XZW. You have only X. So this is not super key. With W, you can only find W. With W, can you find with the help of this functional dependency? No. So this is also not super key. With Z, you can only determine Z. Can you use this functional dependency to determine anything else? No. So this is also not super key. Fine. Okay. So none of the proper subset of XZW is a super key. So this is what candidate key. So finally, the answer for this is you have two super keys and you have two candidate keys. So this is all about today's lecture of candidate key. Thank you so much for watching JavaT Point. Please like, subscribe and share the channel. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.